My, 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 my Lord. Now, I've heard blessed assurance I don't know how many different ways, in inner city settings, in rural settings, in suburban settings, but I believe I'm a little more assured right now.
I'm glad to hear that.
God bless you, man.
Thank you so much.
What an awesome, awesome rendition. Now, tell me, you don't read music.
Cannot read music. I really, really tried, but it just, it didn't click for me. Never really clicked.
How in the world did you, what happened?
You know, I started playing at age 5 or 6. I just had a natural draw to this instrument. And you know how most, I was talking with some of the production crew before the show, and one was talking about taking piano lessons and how mom would put the timer on and you've got to practice, you know, very stringent on that. I was one of those really unusual children that you couldn't get me off the piano bench. My mom was constantly trying to get me off the piano to go outside and play with some of the neighbor kids, you know. And I guess just over time, the passion for the instrument just continued to develop, and you know, I was influenced by classical music, and you kind of can hear that in
yes.
my playing.
Yes.
But then I also, you know, I've got a lot of other influences from other instrumental artists, and one thing led to another, and I started to go into it as a career choice about 10 years ago, and then as little as 5 years ago, decided that this is something God wanted me to incorporate into the church and bless the church as a minstrel and kind of bring a peace and a settlement, just like David played for Saul.
Yeah.
I believe God's called me to be the David for the church and be able to kind of calm us down, because we get so tied up in all of the church things that we're trying to do and all the people that we're trying to impress, and we kind of lose our focus on God and we get stressed out.
Well, I'll tell you what, I sensed that peace as you were playing today, and I just kind of just sit there and relaxed and just wanted to cross my legs and said, David, it's your show, take it, man.
Yeah, well, thank you.
But it was really awesome, really awesome. Now, it's really a miracle.
It
you
is.
Know, it kind of sets the stage for the newest CD that you got out, The Miracle.
Yes.
Tell me a little bit about it.
I'm out of the four albums that I have, and there's one project that has done very well that I'm looking forward to sharing on another visit, but this particular album has a very deep and emotional meaning, not just for me, but for my entire family. It's called The Miracle. And of course, the birth of Christ was a miracle. That was a divine happening, and Mary, you know, giving birth to Jesus. But the miracle for us, and the reason why I titled it that, was because we had a new addition to our three sons about 2 years ago. His name is Aaron. He's our he's our youngest. And before I forget, I promised I would tell my boys that I would say hi to them. So
you must do that.
Joshua, Cole, Brendan, Aaron, I love you guys, and April, I love you too. We'll be home soon.
Amen.
At any rate, though, Aaron was born about 2 years ago, and he was a premature baby.
Okay.
And my wife was suffering from a condition known as placenta previa, which aggravates the pregnancy. And basically what it does is it, I guess there's a promotion of hemorrhaging. There's a lot of episodes of that where there's a blood loss, and of course that kind of induces the labor part of it.
Okay.
So the whole goal for the doctors were to keep Aaron in there as long as possible. And my wife went into the hospital about a week before Thanksgiving and didn't come out until after February, the 1st
wow.
of February. So that entire time she was, you know, and this is through the holidays. Our
yeah.
twin sons, they have their birthdays in December. So, you know, holidays are a real festive and fun time. And for her, it was very miserable. And it was also very difficult having to continue to fight to keep Aaron in the womb long enough so he could survive when he came out. And so it happens to be Christmas Eve. I get a phone call at 1 o'clock in the morning, and it's the doctors, and they're saying, the nurse called and she said, you need to come to the hospital. April's having another episode. We don't know if the baby's gonna stay in this time. So I go to the hospital, and at the time I wasn't feeling well, so I had a mask on and everything. I wasn't allowed to get real close to her to give her any comfort, but the doctors were able to calm things down by the time I got there, and then it just so happened that maybe a minute or two after the doctors left, my wife made this noise of pain. Something hurt, and she said, you better go get the nurse. And where her situation was, she was the closest to the nurse's station. And so all I did was take three steps out, yelled for a nurse. By the time I came back in, and this isn't to be too graphic, but her body fluids were pouring out onto the floor from the bed. Because of so much blood loss. It wasn't even a minute later, she had passed out from blood loss, and they had to rush her into emergency delivery. When it was all said and done, the doctor said maybe 2 minutes. was all that was available there to save her life and the life of Aaron.
Wow.
And of course, Aaron born, he was born just at 32 weeks. That day, he turned 32 weeks old and went into neonatal intensive care unit. And I just got to tell you, the doctors, the nurses, the technology, it's phenomenal. It was amazing to see just what they can do with these beautiful little creations and to help them survive out in the world at such a very early stage. So he was basically 2 months premature. And I need to say this, because I'm sure there are viewers that have had an experience like this, or maybe they know someone who had an experience like this, and they didn't get the same outcome that we did. Maybe that little one was lost, or maybe it wasn't the fortunate event of having both the baby and the mother survive. Maybe something very tragic had happened there. And in sharing my story and my testimony about what God did in our lives, I'm not wanting to bring up any visceral feelings for others. Yeah. And I hope that they can take consolation in knowing that if they are a believer and they know Jesus in their heart and they're going to go to heaven, they're going to see that little one again.
Yeah.
They can take some consolation in that.
Yeah.
So, all that to say this, I wrote a song called Angel Flood, and it really is just to kind of musically represent what I feel God was doing for us at that time, because you feel so hopeless when you're in that situation. You can't turn the TV off that's a movie you don't want to see. You can't walk out of the theater. This is life. You have to rely on the Lord. And, you know, I felt tremendous agony for my wife. I knew the situation was bad. I really didn't realize how bad it was until after the fact. But I called, I only had time to call three people. I called my parents, her parents, and then I called our pastor. And I just asked for them to pray. And because I travel and do church concerts all throughout the United States, we were probably on every prayer chain there was. So we had lots of people praying for us. But I believe God answered that prayer. And I believe that there was just a flood of angels that were in that hospital room that took care of my wife and took care of Aaron, and we got the outcome that we've got. And so that kind of sets up what I want to share with the TCT family. And what it is, it's a video. It's some footage. I took it. You can tell I took it because it's not great. But I took some video footage of everything that happened immediately after he was delivered.
Okay.
They let me take the camera in there, and you can see them hooking up the wires and everything that they do. And at the end of the video, you'll see my wife be able to hold Aaron. And it was 3 days after he was born, because he was in such a delicate state, and she was just incapacitated. And I need to say a disclaimer too. My wife is a beautiful girl, but she's not having her best day on this video. So.